Development Assistance Fund as our own version of the pork barrel. There are a lot of glamours already with the people, especially those who started the Luneta rally, saying that, that should be abolished. And thinking along that line, we also realized that what about the South? What about those people from the Visayas, from city in particular? What is our stand on this issue? And we have decided that we are one of those people in Manila. And that is, we are also in favor of abolishing it. Because we believe that that seems to be the root of the evil right now in our society. And because of that, we would like to make our voice even more louder. And that is by making a signature campaign. Because we want these people in the government to know that we also have our own stand on the issue.
Part of our government. is composed of upper and lower house. The lower house is the House of Congress, and the upper house is the Senate floor. So, collectively, they are known as Congress, the House of Representatives, the lower house, and the Senate. So, PDAF is given debt. The budget is $200 million per senator and $70 million for each member of the House of Representatives. So, I think right now, as of September, 24 billion. Does not go directly in the hands of these legislators. The thing here is that those legislators identify projects. They allocate a budget, and then the implementing agency, public agency, implements it. But the thing we are looking at is the appropriation of lump sum. So it is a lump sum appropriation. The entire appropriation is given to those legislators. And then, it's the part of the priority projects. And this legislators has discretion as to where to put this. They may choose whatever funds they want to put in, but the release of money is forced through the PDAF or Department of Budget Management. And so the role here of the legislators is just to identify projects, allocate funds, and the investment is through the agency. Money is not forced through their hands. Have to remember that. And this project, as I said, is discretionary to the legislators. So they may choose hard infra. We need the hard infra. The hard infrastructures are like the bridges, buildings, or national roads, stations. Those are hard infra projects. And it may also be allocated